This is a short screencast of the fully integrated spirometer for vision from NewMed Healthcare. The test is performed at the PC. The software can be loaded onto any number of computers within the practice. There are no dongles. It's licensed for the entire practice, included any branch surgeries that may be attached. First of all, we go into the patient record. The new consultation is opened. We can then initiate the SpiroLink software by pressing Ctrl, Alt and S on the keyboard. The SpiroLink software will open up, pulling all of the details from the record automatically. In this example, there was no height and weight. First of all though, we need to go to the options box. This will give us an indication as to what we can choose to read code after the test has been performed. Simply place ticks in the boxes of the required tests that you wish read coding. There are also a number of miscellaneous read codes, including whether you wanted the patient height and weight putting back in, whether you want the respiratory flow rate measured. There's lots of things on here that you can do. You would do this once and probably leave those settings now until you wish to change them again at a later date. We can now begin performing the test after we've put the height and weight in. Again, these will be put back onto vision. So we can confirm the details and begin the spirometry test. The window now opens up on the Easy on PC software. You'll see that all the details again are replicated within the appropriate fields. We have some drop-down boxes also on the right-hand side, which we can select the appropriate ethnicity, whether the patient is a smoker, asthma, or COPD. Once we're happy with this, we can press the OK button. We can choose the forced vital capacity or an SVC, relaxed vital capacity. We will go straight into the forced vital capacity in this presentation. So this is the first test. The patient has performed the blow, and you can see the flow volume loop on the left side and the volume time graph. It's telling us that it was a good effort, this particular blow. You can see the results now building up on trial one. So we're now going to do another trial by pressing the Add Trial button. The second blow is performed. We can see again that this was a good effort. We've now got an interpretation because we have the variance between plus or minus 5%, and the interpretation is according to NICE and the new gold standards. And we can see that we have three trials now, and it's telling us that the session is complete. Great job. At this point, we are ready to export to the medical record. So we click on the Finish EMR, Export to Medical Record button. So at that point, the window in front opens, asking us whether we want to send the spirometry to vision now. You can type in some comments. We can send the data now to the record and it will go straight onto the record. But normally, if you wanted to do a post-bronchial dilator test, you'd probably give the patient the inhaler, send them out now for 10 minutes, let them come back in, and we would perform the reversibility test at that point. So we would file the results in one lump after they've done the post-test. We can also preview the spirometry reports as the PDF at this point if we wished, and also we can discard them if we didn't want to place them onto the record for some reason. However, if we send data now to the record, it tells us that the data has been sent to Vision OK, and we can view the attachment in the patient record. So send data. All of the data has been placed onto the record automatically and recoded. And we can also see there's an attachment, an asthma review attachment at the top here. If we click on that, so right click view attachment, you'll see the PDF being displayed. And the PDF can obviously be sent electronically and of course reviewed on anybody's desktop throughout the practice. Useful, it's got the interpretation on, of course all the graphical information, and it will again show all of the post bronchial dilator results on here as well, giving us all the percent changes. It also gives us a lung age if we choose that within the options. So that concludes the short screencast for the Trueflow spirometer with integration into the Vision medical record.